I can sense this distance. This repulsion for me. It's not like a complete disgust, but a resentment. Like a, I guess, ungratefulness. Numb, you know? As if she's over it, but stuck.
Almost ready? It's time to go, Melonhead.
Mom, don't call me that.
We gotta go. Come on.
Can't leave. I don't want to leave. There's so much there. I mean, there's so much there. There's so much invested. You know. I mean, you know better than anybody. I just feel like there's this... I'm standing on this giant rug. And I'm just waiting. I mean, for it to be yanked out from underneath me. I swear. I can feel it coming. All my loyalties. All my dedication. I mean, without it, I'm lost. I'll have nowhere left to go. At least I still have you and Jimmy.
Mom, can I have more cereal?
Make it fast. We gotta go, honey.
Technically, you know we're supposed to get paid, right? Anytime we leave the job, anytime we leave the shop to a job or job to job, we're supposed to get paid. If not have a company vehicle, we're supposed to get paid $0.5 per mile. We're servicemen. You know how much we fucking drive? A lot in service. Vixen, travel cords, motors, whatever. So my boss, who is a cardholder, inherited the company because his dad died. He can't be telling us what to do. But he thinks he can break all the rules because he used to work the field and now he owns the company. And he thinks everybody's out to screw him. So because I'm still a probationary, I brought it up to the e-board last week and I said, listen, I drive with my mechanic as much as I can from job to job. But my boss won't pay me fucking mileage. And they said, that's bullshit. They said that he can't do that. They said that that's against the law. They said, put it down on your time ticket and... He doesn't fucking pay me, man. He doesn't fucking pay me. So my BA, my business associate or whatever.
Taking a shower. Good night.
He doesn't pay you. He doesn't pay you. You tell me. You call me. And, you know, don't even make it a big deal. Just call me. I say, fine. No big deal.
All right. First thing, Schollinger Building in Midtown has issues with the travel cord. That's probably something to do with the junction box, so that'll have to be done first. Second, your favorite, the escalator at the tower keeps stuttering. Sounds like a real pain in the ass, so have fun. Oh yeah, end of the day, wheelchair lift. Now, since Weller isn't here yet, I'm gonna stick him with that one. Well, let him know, he's gotta start being on time. So I'm done letting it slide.
How you been holding up?
I'm all right. As unsure as that sounded, I'm fine. Surprisingly.
Kaufman wants to see you in his office.
He's there now?
Yeah, he's kind of in a weird mood. He said to bring your safety bag.
Great.
Yeah, it's nothing against you. I hate to do it, but I'm gonna have to lay you off.
Wait, what? Why?
It's just not enough work.
Are you firing me?
No, I'm not firing you. I just told you. I'm laying you off. Paul, leave the bag.
Fucking kidding me? Perfect. This is perfect. Don't fucking touch me.
Yeah. Tomorrow? Yes. The Parkview building, right? Absolutely. Okay, thank you. Alright, cheers.
Cheers to that.
Hey.
Right on.
It's good to see you guys.
Absolutely.
Man,
it's
thanks
been a
for
long time.
Out. Yeah. Yeah, I've been kind of fucked up lately. I'm really excited to work for this new company. You know, my fucking ex-boss, man. Oh my god, this guy was
just a hyper.
It's fucking disgusting. I've been on this rant with you guys before
about this
fat Dago motherfucker,
here, right?
Man. I can't fucking stand him, dude. Like, this guy's like 400 pounds. Like, you call him Chunky Charlie. He's got this, he's got big wet lips, they're like the size of his face, and then he just wanted to fucking always remind us of his shitty Italian heritage, and he's from fucking, I don't know, he's from Brooklyn or something like that.
Hey, I'm from Brooklyn, you know what I mean? Like, you know.
Forget about it,
You know, we're gonna have a guy take care of it over here.
Dago, bullshit, man. It was just disgusting. Like, we'd stop, he's gotta go to a special little spot to get his own little cannolis. Like, literally as disgusting as you can imagine, he's always eating. Okay, so we'd get his cannolis, we'd go in the car, and he'd sit there and eat them in front of us. Wouldn't offer them, not that I would want it, even if he did offer it to me, because of the disgusting human being.
He's got
but he'd sit there
crumbs.
And he'd be eating it, like, just, oh my god, he wouldn't breathe through his nose, so you could hear, like, the air just going over the cannoli and just being, like, chewed up. Oh, okay, I get it, you're from Brooklyn, you're Italian, I get
tough
it,
guy,
fucking Dago, bullshit, like, get out of my face, tortellini, Alfredo, whatever.
Hey man, you guys are at the bar. I get it, you look like you're celebrating or whatever. Not trying to be a buzzkill. But you need to cut it with the Dago Wop shit, alright? My buddy over here got kind of a temper.
We had a lot of drinks.
Yeah, everyone's here drinking.
Going through a hard time right now.
Right.
He needs his job.
Relax, hey, relax, relax. Right.
shit. So what'd the other guy look like? It's good to see ya.
You know better than anybody. You're my brother.